Everyone? It's a blessing to be here with you today.
我今天来到这里实在是神的恩典。
We want to thank the leadership of the church for allowing this to happen.
我想感谢教会的教牧团给我这样的机会在这里和大家分享信息。
I'm going to bring up a photo of my family.
Oh, there we go. 我在这里会播放一张我家庭的照片。
And you already heard my beautiful wife sing.
你已经听到我美丽的太太给大家唱歌了。
And you can also see that we have three very handsome sons.
而且你们看到我有三个非常帅气的儿子。
And I have good news for you today.
我今天要带给你们一个好信息。
Two of them are still available.
其中两个人还是单身。
So if anyone wants to talk to us afterwards, that's okay.
所以你们在会后如果想跟我交谈一下的话，我是很愿意的。
We, as a family, have the privilege of serving Jesus.
我们整个家庭很荣幸可以来侍奉我们的主耶稣基督。
And we have the chance to minister in churches across Canada.
而且我们有机会在全加拿大各地的教会服事。
But it's a very big blessing for us to be here with you.
但是今天依然是我们很大的祝福，让我们可以在这里和大家一道聚会。
Today I'd like to share with you about the priorities of Jesus.
今天我想和大家分享的是耶稣的优先抉择。
When I was a small boy, I would always go to a special place.
当我还是一个小孩子的时候，我常常去一个特别的地方。
It was a place near our town.
这个地方就在我家附近。
Where three rivers joined together and made one river.
那里有三条小的河流汇聚成一条大的河流。
And we would go there and watch it for a long time.
我们会在那里就看着河流淌，看很久很久。
It was so amazing to us.
那里景色非常的美丽。
It was so beautiful and powerful.
看上去非常的波澜壮阔。
And I think that's a good picture of what it means to follow Jesus.
我想那几条河流的景色向我们诠释了怎样是跟随耶稣。
When we receive Jesus, our lives are like a small river.
当我们接受主耶稣基督的时候，我们的人生就像一条小小的河流的分支。
And then we learn one of the priorities of Jesus.
然后我们知道耶稣的一个优先的选择。
And we start to live that out in our lives.
我们就开始在我们生活当中进行实践。
And a stream is added to that first stream.
然后这些小的分支开始汇流了。
And then we learn another priority of Jesus.
然后我们知道另外一个耶稣的优先选择。
And we start to live it out.
我们开始实践它。
And a stream is added to that one.
然后这条小的河流又与我们的生命汇合。
And eventually our lives are a wide river.
那最后我们的生命就像一条大河一样。
And we have a beautiful and a powerful testimony.
我们会有一个非常美丽的、有力的见证。
And people can look at our lives.
人们看到我们的生活、生命。
And they can see what it means to follow Jesus.
他们会知道什么叫做跟随耶稣基督。
So today I want to invite you on a journey.
所以今天我想邀请你们参加这样一个旅程。
And I want to invite you to lean in close to the heart of Jesus.
我想邀请你们紧贴耶稣的胸膛。
And ask that you would listen to hear his heartbeat.
我想邀请你们去听耶稣的心跳声。
Listen to hear what the heart of Jesus beats for.
希望你们知道耶稣的心是向着什么地方而去。
Today we want to focus on three of the top priorities.
今天我们将会关注耶稣三个优先的选择。
So let's lean in close and hear his heart.
所以让我们来投靠着耶稣胸膛，听他的心跳声。
The first group that are close to the heart of Jesus are the lost.
那第一组人紧靠耶稣胸膛的是失丧的人。
We read in Matthew chapter 28.
我们在马太福音二十八章看到这样一句话。
About Jesus' heart for the nations.
我们看到耶稣向着万国万民的心。
He wants people from every tribe and nation and tongue to come to him.
耶稣希望万国万族万方的民可以来归向他。
To know his salvation and his goodness.
知道他的救恩，知道他的恩慈良善。
His healing and his faithfulness.
他的拯救，他的医治，他的信实。
And his restoration in their lives.
而且他在他们生命当中的这个工作。
I remember what it was like to be lost.
我想我知道什么叫做失丧的。
And to not know Jesus.
什么叫做不认识耶稣。
And I remember as a young boy closing my eyes at night.
我记得我还年幼的时候有一些场景会 在我的眼前浮现。
And seeing only blackness.
仅仅是看到一些黑色的东西。
And wondering, will that be what it's like when I die?
而且会想着，难道我死了之后就这样吗？
Isn't there something more to life?
我生命当中还会有些其他的东西吗？
And all the friends around me would say, I know where you can find life.
我身边的朋友会告诉我说，我知道你在哪里可以找到生命。
And they would get me to experiment in lots of different things.
然后他们会带着我去尝试不同的东西。
And everything that I experimented with
那我所尝试的每一样东西
ended up leaving me feeling more empty after I tried that thing.
但是当我尝试过之后，我就感到越发的虚空。
It's a terrible thing to be lost.
失丧是一件非常让人感觉糟糕的东西。
And to not know where to find life.
不知道哪里可以找到生命的方向。
To not know Jesus.
不知道谁是耶稣基督。
I'll show you a picture of a little girl named Kat.
我想让你们看一组图，看一张图片。这个小女孩叫做小猫。
She's the little one, which is her nickname. But she's sitting right in front of her father.
她就坐在她爸爸的前面。
And she was a little girl growing up in Thailand.
她是一个泰国的小女孩。
And as you know, there is very few people who know Jesus in Thailand.
在泰国很少的人认识耶稣基督。
There's a small, a very, an unlikely chance of you coming to know Jesus.
你认识耶稣基督的机会是非常小的。
She was also growing up in poverty.
而且她生活在贫困当中。
And sometimes when children are growing up in poverty in Thailand,
有些时候当小孩子在这个贫困当中生活的时候，
they will get sold into the sex trade.
他们会被贩卖给人口贩子，然后就做那种性交易。
So it was not a safe place for a little girl to be growing up.
所以那里对于小女孩来说并不是一个安全的地方。
But our family had the blessing of sponsoring little Kat.
但是我们的整个家庭有这样的祝福来支持赞助这个小女孩。
And she began to hear about the amazing love of Jesus.
于是她就有机会听到耶稣对她的爱是何等奇妙。
And she received Jesus into her life.
然后她接受耶稣基督进入她的生命当中。
Every 4 minutes in the ministry of compassion,
那每四分钟，那恩惠事工呢？
A child is coming to Jesus.
就会带领一个小孩子来认识耶稣。
And she was one of them.
她就是其中一个。
She started to grow in her faith.
她在她的信仰过程当中逐渐的成长。
She became a leader in her compassion center.
那她成为了一个就是这个恩惠事工在泰国的一个小小的领袖。
And she got vocational training.
她得到了职业化的训练。
And eventually we got a letter from the director of her center.
那最后呢，我们是有她的这样一个等于是总监吧，给我们写了一封信。
And the director said, "You might not have known this."
这个总管说，你也许知道什么是孤单。
But not only did Kat come to know Jesus.
但是不仅仅这个小女孩认识了耶稣基督。
Also, her whole family came to know Jesus.
她整个的家庭都认识了耶稣基督。
Everyone in her family.
她家庭当中的每一个人。
And I want you to know this is normal in the ministry of compassion.
我想让你知道，这是在恩惠事工当中非常正常的一个现象。
When one child comes to Jesus in the ministry of compassion,
当其中一个小孩子借着恩惠事工认识耶稣基督的时候，
an average of another 4 family members also come to know Jesus.
平均下来，其他的四个家庭成员也会认识耶稣基督。
That means in about every 1 minute, someone's coming to know Jesus.
这就意味着差不多是每一分钟都有人来借着恩惠事工认识耶稣。
And we want to invite you here today.
今天我想邀请大家
to have your heart beat for the lost.
让你的心为失丧的人而跳动。
The second group that we're looking at today are the least.
那第二组人我们要看的呢，就是最小的。
We read in Matthew chapter 25.
我们看马太福音25章。
That at the end of time, Jesus will come back.
当世界末了的时候，耶稣会再来。
And he will look at my life and your life.
他会来审视你我的生活。
And he will make an evaluation.
他会进行评价判断。
And he will notice what was important to us.
他会知道什么对于我们来说是重要的。
And in this passage, we see
那在这段经文当中
that he wants the least of these to be important to us.
他希望人群当中最小的可以成为我们生命当中非常重要的一部分人。
He calls them brothers and sisters.
他称呼这群最小的人是他的弟兄姊妹。
And he says that we'll get rewarded according to how we treat them.
而且他告诉我们说我们会根据我们如何去对待这些最小的人而得到奖赏。
This man is Everett Swanson.
这个人是叫艾弗雷特斯旺森。
And he was invited to preach in the nation of Korea.
他曾经被邀请在韩国传道。
During the Korean War.
在韩战期间。
And he saw there that there were thousands of abandoned children out in the streets.
他看到有千万计的流离失所的儿童。
And he saw that every day garbage workers or sanitation workers would go out into the streets.
他们会看他每天都会看到街上都有一些清洁工在街上去收垃圾。
And some of the piles of garbage they would pick up and put on the truck.
那有一些垃圾堆呢，他们会抬起来就放到卡车上。
And some piles of garbage they would leave in the streets.
那有一些垃圾堆呢，他们就不管了，就把他们放在街上。
And he asked someone what's going on in your country.
对，斯旺森这个人呢，就找到新人就问你们的国家到底怎么一回事情呢
？And the local person said that the children get very cold at night.
当地人就告诉他说，这些小孩子在晚上的时候非常冷。
And they pile some rags and newspapers on top of themselves.
所以他们就把破衣烂衫、报纸啊、垃圾啊，就往自己身上盖。
So that maybe they can survive one more day.
所以他有可能就是再活一个晚上。
So when the workers come along and see these piles,
所以当这些清洁工在街上清理垃圾，看到这些垃圾堆的时候
，they'll kick the piles.
所以他们就会踢这个垃圾堆。
And if the pile moves,
如果这个垃圾堆哎看到在动
，then they leave the child there.
所以他们就让这个小孩子就在那儿就不管这垃圾堆了。
And if they come along and they are kicking the pile,
那如果他们踢这个垃圾堆
，and there's no movement,
没有动静
，they're scooping up the child and the garbage and putting them on the truck.
他们就会连小孩带这个垃圾就一并就铲到这个卡车上面去。
And every day, they're coming through and taking these children to the dump.
所以每一天他们就会。带着这些垃圾，连同这个垃圾堆底下小孩子，把他们放到那个垃圾焚烧厂。
Everett Swanson saw this, and he knew that this was not good.
他看到这样的景象，这个人知道这样景象是非常糟糕的。
And he was flying home, and he felt that God was speaking to him.
当他返程坐飞机返程的时候，他就觉得神在不断敲打他的心。
And God was saying, "What are you going to do? What are you going to do?"
神在说，你到底要怎么样做？你应该怎么样做？
So he gathered some friends together.
所以他把一些朋友召聚在一起。
And they decided that they would take care of these children.
他们决定我们要来照看这些被遗弃的儿童。
So that they would not get hauled away like trash.
以至于他们不用被像垃圾一样被拖走。
And they were the very first Compassion International sponsors.
这就是一开始恩惠施工的这些资助者。
And now.Today, there's 2 million children sponsored with compassion around the world.
所以今天全世界有200万被这个恩惠机构资助的儿童。
In 25 of the world's poorest countries.
在25个世界最贫穷的国家当中都有这样的孩子。
But that wasn't the end of the story in Korea.
但这个并不是这个韩国故事这样结束。
The church became very powerful.
那韩国教会现在已经变得非常的兴盛。
And the economy became very strong.
经济也越来越好。
And the Korean church was able to take care of their own people.
所以韩国教会现在已经可以去照顾他们自己的小孩子了。
And they said to the leaders of the Korean church said to Compassion.
所以教会的领袖呢就跟对恩惠施工说
，You can leave.
你们可以走了。
And we'll take care of the least of these.
我们自己来照看这些最小的。
But you will be back.
但是你们会回来。
And we will be taking care of the least of these in other countries.
我们呢就开始照顾全世界其他国家的这些贫穷的小孩子。
And that's what happened.
这样的事情也真的发生了。
The president of Compassion came back to Korea.
恩惠施工的主席呢，有一天真的就回到了韩国。
And he was reintroducing, Compassion to Korea.
他重新把这样的施工介绍给韩国人。
And he was giving an amazing speech.
他讲了一篇非常有力的信息。
Just like this speech.
就像这样的信息一样。
And over on this side, a man was waving his arms.
差不多就在那个位置，有一个男人站起来来那个摇手。
And he said, it looks like you have something to say.
然后这个 这个讲员就说、哎、看来你有一些话想讲。
And the man said, you don't need to tell us about compassion.
那个人就说呢，你不需要跟我们讲什么是恩惠的事工。
We are your children.
我们是你的孩子。
And he had been one of those boys who would have been hauled away like trash.
他就是其中一个差点被像垃圾一样拖走的那个小孩子。
And now he was a leader in his church and in his denomination.
但是现在他已经是他的那间教会和那间宗派的一个领袖了。
And then all over the room, men and women began to stand up.
然后呢，在整个的会场有许多的男女的弟兄姊妹就站起来。
And they were saying, I'm your daughter.
他们说，我们是你的女儿。
I'm your son.
啊，我们是你的儿子。
And they had all been released from poverty.
他们都被从贫困当中被救拔出来。
And they were Christian leaders in all the different parts of Korean society.
然后有许许多多的教会的领袖分散在韩国各地。
And God had used these little ones
神使用了这些最小的
to transform the whole nation.
来改变整个国家。
So let's allow our hearts to beat like the heart of Jesus.
所以让我们的心和耶稣的心是一样的。
Let's allow our hearts to beat for the least.
让我们的心为最小的而跳动。
The third group we want to look at today.Are the littlest.
那第三组我们要看的就是最年幼的这一组人。
When we read the Gospels,
当我们在读福音书的时候
we see that little people are a big priority to Jesus.
我们看到这年幼的小孩子往往是耶稣的优先选择。
Jesus wants children to be protected.
耶稣希望小孩子被保护。
He wants them to be cared for.
耶稣希望他们被照看。
He wants them to have a very clear path to come to him.
他希望这些小孩子到他面前的这个路径不被拦阻。
And that's our job as disciples.
这就是我们作为耶稣的门徒当做的事情。
We have a very simple job.
我们有一个非常简单的工作可以做。
Make it easy for little ones to come to him.
让这些年幼的小朋友可以轻而易举地来到耶稣的面前。
Children in every culture in the world.
那小孩来自全世界不同文化、不同国家的小孩子。
Are drawn to Jesus.
被吸引到耶稣的面前。
This is a picture of a young man named Jonathan.
这幅图画让我们看到有一个年轻的人，他的名字叫做 Jonathan 约拿丹。
And we met him in the Dominican Republic.
我们见到他的时候呢，是在这个多米尼加共和国。
While he was working for the Ministry of Compassion.
当他在为恩惠事工服务的时候。
And he has a fire inside of his heart.
他内心里面是充满了火热。
And a desire for more children to get sponsored.
他希望更多的小孩子可以被资助。
Because he himself was released from poverty.
因为他自己就是借着这样的事工被从贫穷当中拯救出来的。
He told us that when he was just 7 years old.
他告诉我们当他只有七岁的时候。
He was sent out into the streets every day by his mother.
他被他的妈妈每天就赶到大街上。
And she would say, Jonathan,
妈妈会跟他说，约拿丹
，Go sell these little bags of juice.
去把这一小包饮料卖掉。
And if you can sell enough of them,
如果你可以再卖一包
，then we can eat today.
然后我们今天的饭食就有着落了。
So he went out as a little boy salesman out into the streets.
所以他每一天呢，就走到大街上去贩卖饮料。
Jonathan had also been born as a result of a secret affair.
他也是一个因为婚外情而降生的一个小孩子。
And when this man's family found out about the secret, which was Jonathan,
当他这个生父的家庭发现了这个秘密的时候，就是这个小孩子的时候
，he got very angry, very embarrassed.
那他的生父就非常的生气，也非常的恼羞成怒。
And he came to little Jonathan.
他就走到这个年幼的这个约拿丹面前。
And he said, Jonathan, you were a mistake.
他跟约拿丹说，你就是一个意外的错误。
I never want to see you again.
我永远不想再见到你。
So this little boy is growing up in poverty.
所以这个小男孩呢，他是在贫困当中成长的。
And poverty is telling him lies about who he is.
这个贫穷呢，就给他有个错误的认识，他不知道他是谁。
And he was trapped in the same problems that other generations had been trapped in.
所以他和他前面几代的这些父母长辈一样，都陷在同样的问题里面。
But he got sponsored with compassion.
但是他得到恩惠事工的资助。
And after he got rejected by his father,
那他在被他的父亲撵走之后
，He went home and read a letter from his compassion sponsor.
所以他然后呢，他就在家里面读到一封信，是他的资助者写给他的。
And his sponsor said, Jonathan.
资助者对他说，约拿丹。
Today I'm thinking of all the things that I'm grateful for.
今天我就想到许许多多我为之而感谢的事情。
And I want you to know I'm grateful for you.
然后我想让你知道我为你而向神献上感谢。
So Jonathan started to have the truth spoken about him.
所以约拿丹就看到他自己到底是一个什么样的人。
And he went to the compassion center every day.
然后他就去这个恩惠施工在当地的中心。
And he heard that God saw him.
他能够感觉到神在看他。
And that God heard his prayers.
神听到他的祷告。
And that God was powerful.
神是大能的。
And that God had given him gifts and abilities.
神给他各种各样的恩赐和能力。
And he started to walk around his neighborhood in a different way.
所以于是呢，他就在自己的这个小社区走来走去，以不一样的这种姿态。
He would puff out his chest like a big bullfrog.
他像一个牛蛙一样把胸膛挺起来。
And he had fire in his eyes.
然后他的这个眼睛里面充满了这个火焰。
And he would act like he owned the whole neighborhood.
他走起路来就好像整个社区都是他的。
And he would, as he walked through the neighborhood,
当他在这个街道上走的时候
he would be thinking, God is with me.
他在想的是神与我同在。
God can change my country.
神可以改变我的国家。
So it was a great day when we finally got to meet Jonathan.
当我们见到约拿丹的那一天是非常美好的一天。
A big group of his friends said, you have to meet Jonathan.
有一大群约拿丹朋友跟我们说，你必须要见一见这个小孩子，见这个人。
They took us over to where he was.
然后他就把我们带到了约拿丹的面前。
And I reached out my hand to shake his hand.
然后我就把手伸出去要和他握手。
And they said, "This is Jonathan."
然后他们说这个就是约拿丹。
And he is going to be the president of the Dominican Republic.
他将会成为多米尼加共和国的总统。
And I had a very funny look on my face.
然后我的脸 就觉得很好，就脸上表情就觉得这个故事真好笑。
And、his friends said, "Maybe you didn't hear us."
他的朋友就说，也许你并没有听说过我们。
Our friend Jonathan is going to be the president of the Dominican Republic.
我们的朋友约拿丹会成为多米尼加共和国的总统。
And he's running now to be a senator.
那约拿丹现在正在为成为议员而竞选。
And his friends are his campaign team.
那他的同伴呢，都是他这个竞选团队的成员。
And they have a five-year campaign.
他们会有一个五年期的竞选。
And the election is next year.
那明年就是大选了。
And he has a great chance of winning.
他有很大的机会赢得议员的席位。
He knows that God wants him to be a leader at a national level.
他相信神会带领他成为这个国家的一个领袖。
And to change policies in his country.
然后去改变这个国家的政策。
So that it's easier for other boys and girls to come out of poverty.
以至于其他的小孩子可以有更多的机会从贫困当中脱离。
But none of that happens unless someone notices seven-year-old Jonathan.
这个是不可能发生的，除非在约拿丹七岁的时候有人注意到他。
And makes an investment into his life.
然后在他的生命当中投资。
And prays for him.
为他祷告。
And speaks the truth to him.
然后向他去传讲真理。
This afternoon, let's allow our hearts to beat with the heart of Jesus.
今天下午让我们的心和耶稣的心同心。
For the littlest, the littlest.
为最年幼的这一群人而跳动。
We love the ministry of compassion, because it allows us to care for the lost, the least, and the littlest.
我们恩惠事工关注的就是这三组人：世上的最小的和最年幼的。
Over 80% of the children that come into the program.
超过80%被恩惠施工照顾的儿童
are coming from non-Christian homes.
是从非基督徒的家庭当中出来的。
Over 80% come from families that make less than $2 a day.
超过80%的儿童来自非常贫困的家庭，这些家庭每一天只有2块钱的收入。
So you can know for certain.
所以你们可以确实的知道
that when you sponsor a child with compassion.
当你通过恩惠施工赞助儿童的时候
，You're caring for the lost, the least, and the littlest.
你正在关注最年幼的、最小的和失丧的。
But sometimes people ask us, what makes compassion different from other ministries?
那你可能会问我们说，恩惠事工和其他的事工有何不同？
And the answer that there are four things that make compassion different.
有四点是恩惠事工的特点。
And I'll cover these very briefly.
我会简单的向大家介绍这四点。
First of all, compassion is Christ-centered.
第一个，我们是以基督为中心的。
The best way to lead someone out of poverty.
引人脱离贫困最好的方式。
Is to introduce them to Jesus.
就是把他们去引向耶稣基督。
Compassion is also child-focused.
恩惠事工也是关注儿童的。
How many of you came to know Jesus before you reached the age of 15?
有多少？我们当中有多少人是十五岁之前认识耶稣基督？请把手举起来。
Go ahead and raise your hand. Yeah. So most people come to know Jesus before they reach the age of 15.
大多数人在认识耶稣基督的时候还不到十五岁。
But very often we don't take advantage of those early years to reach people.
但是很多时候我们并没有在一个人最黄金的年龄去帮助他们认识耶稣基督。
Compassion is also church-based.
恩惠事工也是以教会为基础的。
There we go. Everything that compassion does is done through a local church.
那恩惠事工所做的事工都是借着教会去进行的。
So in 5 years, the church is still there.
所以五年之后呢，教会还在那个地方。
In 25 years, the church is still there.
25年之后，教会还在那里。
And they're caring for the people in their neighborhood.
他们会照看他们社区的小孩子。
Fourthly, compassion is committed to financial integrity.
那第四点就是他们的财政诚信度，我们的财政诚信度很高。
Whenever compassion is audited or examined,
当这个恩惠机构被审计的时候
，It comes out as one of the top charities in the world.
它总是在慈善机构当中排名是领先的。
For financial integrity.
在这个诚信可靠度这一项上。
Now let's take a moment and look at this video.
让我们花点时间来看这一个视频片段。
And it will show the kind of impact that you can have.
这个视频会让你们看到，你们可以在别人的生命当中产生何等的影响力。
When you sponsor a child with compassion.
当你借着恩惠事工去赞助小孩子的时候。
Nothing was the same for me. My mother had no job. My father was the only breadwinner. We moved from where we stayed to a place called Naguru Kasenke, which is one of Uganda's largest slums. And then I was introduced to our new home.Which was a 12 by 12 room. I looked up on the roof. It was a tin roof that had holes in it. That was a night that we would stay standing. Get little buckets placed just where the holes in the roof are and wait until morning. A reality hit me that day, that this was life. Poverty began to speak to me as a child. I felt I was nothing. I didn't matter.Nobody cared to know my name. I think the best way I could describe who I was and what I thought is the word hopeless. My mother, in tears, approached one of her friends just to share with her friend. And her friend shared with her about compassion. Compassion staff members immediately came to our home. I remember them coming with files to get details of who we were, what our story was.I got the news that a young lady, Heather, she was 15 years old, a teenager. She had decided to sponsor me. I cannot find the words to describe the joy that filled our home when we got the news. Richmond, you've got a sponsor, which means you can now go back to school. That ushered in me an opportunity.To rekindle this hope that was taken away. Heather began to write to me. To hear words like, Richmond, I love you. Richmond, I'm praying for you. They began to bring healing into places that were destroyed by voices and poverty and my self-image. I credit a lot of how I feel now about myself to those letters that I received from my sponsor. June the 3rd, 1996.I walked forward to accept the Lord Jesus in my heart. I began to feel, wow, I have been released from poverty. I have been released. God began to continue to grow the leadership within me. And then I felt fully called to pursue pastoral ministry. I began the Pastors Discipleship Network, a ministry that exists to train and equip pastors. And I spend a lot of my life training and equipping pastors in the Word of God. Looking back into my life and thinking where I am right now and what I'm doing, I don't think any of this would have been possible without compassion. Compassion works. Everything that was placed within the program has helped build me to who I am right now. Poverty is not just the lack of money, the lack of material, food, and water. Poverty is in. It's deep. My name is Richmond Wandera, and I was released from poverty in Jesus' name.
So today we'd like to give you an opportunity.
今天我想给大家一个机会。
To release a child from poverty in Jesus' name.
把奉耶稣基督的名，把一个小孩子从贫困当中
脱离出来。To take a step of action.
采取进一步的行动。
And to care for the lost, the least, and the littlest.
来帮助最年幼的、最小的和失丧的。
So we'd like to invite you to come to the back after the service.
我想邀请你在会后呢。到这个我们会堂的后面
and pick out one of these children to sponsor.
选择一个小孩子去资助他。
The first part will tell you about the child.
那第一部分呢会告诉你这个小孩子的一些信息。
And the other two parts you fill out and you leave with us.
那第二栏和第三栏是一些你需要提供的信息，你需要填这样的表格。
Sponsoring with compassion is $41 a month.
你如果要赞助一个小孩子的话呢，是$41一个月。
And it only takes a moment to fill out this form.
你填这张表只需要花你一点点时间。
But it will change the child's life for an eternity.
但是会改变那个小孩子在永恒当中的生命。
And if you sponsor a child with compassion today,
那如果你今天借着恩惠事工赞助小孩子的话呢
，We would like to give you a small thank you gift.
我们会给你一些。表达感谢的礼物
and that's a copy of this worship album.
你会得到这样一张 CD 的专辑
and it's recorded by my favorite songwriter of all time.
这是我最喜欢的一位歌手写的歌，唱的歌。
It's my wife.
这就是我的太太。
So please come to the table, and we'd love to help you.
所以请到那个后面有一张桌子那边，然后我们会帮助你填写这样的表格。
And answer any questions that you may have.
然后会帮助你解答一些问题。
I'd like to say thank you again to the leadership of your church.
我想再一次对教会的教牧团表示感谢。
And I also want to thank you as a church family.
然后我也想对整个教会大家庭表示感谢。
Thank you for being a church that loves the lost, the least, and the littlest.
感谢你们，神让你们成为一间关注最年幼的、最小的和失丧的群体的教会。
God bless you.
神祝福大家。